Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Easy Learning. In this video we will discuss about the chapter Food Production Part 3. Part 1 and Part 2 had been already discussed with you in my previous videos. In Part 3 we will discuss about manure versus fertilizer. Differentiate between manure and fertilizers. First we will discuss about the fertilizers. That what are fertilizers? Inorganic chemical substances rich in plant nutrients are called fertilizers. They are prepared in factories. They do not provide humus to soil. They are not very bulky and easy to handle. They reduce the fertility of the soil in the long run, if they are used in the long run. Next is, we will discuss about manures. What are manures? Natural organic substances obtained by the animal and human wastes are called manure. They can be prepared in the fields. They provide humus to the soil. They are quite bulky and difficult to transfer from one place to another. Soil fertility can also be improved by using the following techniques. There are some techniques, and the first techniques from them is fallow field. A fallow field is one which is left unseeded between planting seasons for some time so that nutrients are replenished in the soil. And the second technique is crop rotation. Two or more crops are grown on the same soil alternatively so that the soil is not deprived of any particular nutrient. Leguminous crops such as pulses and beans are sown in one season, and cereal crops such as wheat and maize are sown in the next season on the same field is the example of crop rotation. Now we will talk about irrigation. Crops need the right amount of water to grow properly. Water is necessary for the absorption of nutrients, minerals and fertilizers by the crop. The supply of water to agriculture fields at regular intervals of time is called irrigation. Water for irrigation is obtained from various sources. Wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers are sources of irrigation. There are so many methods of irrigation, and one method from them is sprinkler system. This method is effective in irrigating sandy regions and regions with uneven land which have an insufficient water supply. Water flows from the main pipe into smaller pipes with the help of pumps. Now, the next one is very important. It is drip irrigation. It is drip irrigation. This method is very good for areas with low water availability, as there is no wastage of water in this method. In this method, water is supplied through a network of pipes which directly falls drop by drop onto the soil near the root zone of the plants. It is very useful for watering fruit trees and orchards. So, thank you guys for watching my channel, for watching this video. We will meet you in next video. So thank you so much. Please like and subscribe.